What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. Today we are reviewing the 85 in form Joe Gomez. We did get very lucky, packed him from silver one, red obviously, which is basically my first pack luck of the year, so I'm really gassed and I just thought I had to review him for you guys. So he does have good links to Walker, Wan-Bissaka, Van Dijk, so Liverpool, England, Premier League, very linkable. 6'2", which is decent for a centre-back, should feel quite strong and like should bully the attackers. We have stuck a shadow on him just to max out that pace in defending with the like 97 sprint speed and 90 acceleration. He should feel absolutely rapid. Defending doesn't matter too much. Passing, again, it's a bit irrelevant in this game, but obviously it's still not the best. Like, at least he's got short passing at 82, but the long passing at 68 might affect him a bit. Dribbling, the reactions is really nice. The composure's a little low, but apart from that, dribbling doesn't really matter for your centre-backs. So, going on to the big stats now, the defending, where the shadow has 96 interceptions, 81 heading accuracy if you do like doing them headers from corners, which I will be testing a bit. 90 defensive awareness, 97 stand tackle and 99 slide tackle. So basically, if you're in a tackle, you're gonna win the ball. The physicals look decent, 78 jumping, 76 stamina, which is decent for a centre back, and 85 strength and 83 aggression. If you really like, you could put an anchor on him to improve those physicals, but as I said, I have put a shadow on him. We will be playing him centre back next to Mukiele in a 4-2-2 along with the likes of St. Maximan, Zaha, Sissoko and Dembele, and I'll catch you in the games.
Nice. Not just the tackle that was needed. Promising move. Well, spot on with that. And the corner played over by Dembele. He'll be delighted. Sofsky. Moving it forward. Excellent defending. And they could face difficulties here. That's
been impressive. They just need a bit of magic or a bit of luck. They will take either, I'm sure, at this stage.
Marco Reus. Wanted to keep it, but couldn't.
I don't know how. Technique was all right, but he didn't expect the goalkeeper to be that good.
Well, it looked... Sané. Sané. Well, no way through. Lukaku waiting, and the problem not completely solved. And a time for cool heads. Mertens. It's a perfect challenge. Best. Martinez. And able to get a body in the way. Body in the way. Martinez, denied again. Could face difficulties here. Lukaku! Able to... And the defender coming out on top against Lukaku. Excellent block. Lukaku. Might be dangerous. Well, they couldn't take advantage of the position they were in. And this is the initial 11 for the visitors. Well, what can they do to stop him running at them? Sissoko. Dembele. And the referee doesn't hesitate. That is a spot kick. Well, that could be his final rebuke, I think, and the referee's making that absolutely clear.
Well, I like that, Derek. Good refereeing. Nice and strong. Told the player exactly what he was thinking.
A horrific miss.
Juice in the second half.
Oh, it's gone in! And you have to... And can they make one of these passes count? And just like that, they've lost Ndombele. The referee has decided that two additional minutes are in order.
We are back after the games, and now we'll be answering the questions all of you will have. Is he worth it over the base card? So, we have played three games with him. The 6'2", as we know, like, he's just a bullying game. Just didn't let a single attacker like push him off the ball. Just great. The pace, 10 out of 10. Like, he just, even if he's like a meter away behind, he'll still catch up to them and body them off the ball. Like, with the 97 sprint speed, just excellent for tracking back, and 90 acceleration if you need that quick burst of pace. Passing, I'll give 7.5 out of 10. Nothing special, but did the job. But I wouldn't really take that into much, like, into your decision on buying him, because passing is just like, it's just not great in this game. There's not much of a difference between like 69 and 99 passing. Dribbling. He actually felt okay, like, just like if you're trying to like do ball rolls once you've bodied them, but I wouldn't recommend going on skill runs, obviously. Defending, 10 out of 10, just like the interceptions, 96, like just everything, even the slide tackles at 99 and the stance tackle at 97, just he just would never not come out with the ball. Like, sometimes you might have some quick defenders with okay defending, and they'll get the tackle in, but it might just like rebound back off them straight to the attacker, but that never happened with him. Physicals, 9.5 out of 10. Like, just great strength and aggression. Definitely feels higher than 85 strength. He feels like 90, but I guess like, that just comes with his building game. He's like really stocky and like just a beast. Stamina was a little low, and jumping wasn't the best. Like, a lot of the time he didn't win them headers, but no real traits. So overall, 10 out of 10. Like, there's not many better non-icon centre backs in the game. Maybe Van Dijk. He's on level with like Varane, so definitely probably like top three best non-icon centre back in the game. Is he worth the price? First of all, like, I'll give him value for price 9 out of 10. Obviously, he is like just such a beast, but I think you can get like Van Dijk for the price, so it's just up to you if you would rather get Van Dijk or Gomez. And is it worth it over his base card? Yeah, I do think so. I was using his base card before I packed his red, and I don't know, sometimes it was a bit weak in the challenge, but this card was just like a monster. If you have the coin, I would definitely recommend you upgrading him. Anyway, guys, thank you for watching. Hopefully you did enjoy, and I'll catch you in the next video. Like and subscribe if you're new.